everyone, Salty Swimmer here from Endurance Swimming, liquidtry.com. Go like, go subscribe, do all that fun stuff. Today, I'm here to talk to you about one thing, bilateral breathing, why you should do it. If you don't know what bilateral breathing is, it's very simple. It means you're breathing to both sides, right? Breathe to the left or breathe to the right. Now, I'm not saying that you need to breathe every three strokes or breathe every five strokes. What I'm saying today is that you need to be able to breathe comfortably to either side, all right? So there's two main reasons why I recommend that you bilateral breathe. And I do enjoy breathing every three. And that's the first reason. The first reason is because it balances out your stroke. So when you're always breathing to one side, you're loading up your shoulder, you're loading up the trap on the side you're not breathing to. What that means is you're gonna look like Quasimodo, where you got one trap that's huge and then one that's not developed at all. This is very problematic because this is gonna lead to injuries, it's gonna lead to slower swimming, it's gonna lead to inefficiencies in your stroke. So if you're not comfortable breathing every three, what you could do to get comfortable breathing to both sides is you do your warm up and your warm down and some of your lighter sets breathing to your bad side. And then you do all your main sets where you have to go fast breathing to your good side. And that way you're at least gonna create balance in the stroke. But it's just easier to me to be able to breathe every three strokes. Then you don't have to worry about, oh, did I breathe to the left on this side this time? And did I breathe to the right this time? You just do it every three, you get really comfortable with it. That's the first reason. Now the second reason is the more important reason if you are doing a marathon swim, and if you're a marathon swimmer, I hope you know how to breathe both ways, but if you're doing a marathon swim or a triathlon or an open water race, it's or even a pool race, honestly, if you're outdoors, there are many different environmental conditions that can impact your swimming. So if, for example, if you only know how to breathe to the right, okay, and you are swimming in a race, and it's you're gonna go out, you're gonna take a left, and then you're gonna come, and then you're gonna swim into shore. If the waves are breaking to the side you're breathing to all the time, you might never get air. Or if you're breathing to the opposite side, you'll never see a wave coming. So you might get pummeled by waves. So it's really important so that you know what's going on around you to be able to breathe both sides. Another example is the sun, all right? Even if you have polarized goggles, you look at the sun, it blinds you, right? That's what it's supposed to do. So if you are in a race and you're breathing, you only know how to breathe to the left and the sun's shining to the left, but not to the right, every time you take a stroke to breathe, you're getting the sun right in your face. So you're gonna have a really hard time seeing where you're going, even when you're sighting, because you're always gonna have that like that blinding light. So if you know how to breathe both ways, you can turn your head, breathe to the other side, and you don't have to worry so much about where you are in the swim. So it's really important to be able to breathe both sides. And again, it doesn't mean for the race you have to breathe every three. It doesn't mean you have to breathe every five. You can breathe to one side or the other a whole time, but it's really helpful if you know how to breathe both ways comfortably, because you never know what's gonna happen. You might get pummeled by a wave on one side, then you have to turn your head right away to catch another breath. But if you're not comfortable breathing that side, you're just constantly gonna be taking in water and it's gonna be a real struggle. So top two reasons why you need to bilateral breathe. One is balance, and two, it's so that you're ready for any condition come race day. Hopefully you found this quick tip helpful. If you did, like, subscribe, share with your friends. If you didn't, like, subscribe, and hate watch this, but I think you'll find it helpful. So I hope you have a great race season. I hope your training's great, and try practicing bilateral breathing. See you all on the other side.